So one of the men that Albert Pike admired very much was a man named Adam Weinstock, and as we discussed earlier, Adam Weinstock was a figurehead for the Illuminati at the time they celebrated their May Day. And to keep in mind, May 1st is actually a communist holiday too. And so this kind of shows you from the east to the west, the Illuminati's far-reaching effects. And so Adam Weinstock, at the time of the celebration of the Illuminati's plans and the rising of a rebellious country, which later became America, Adam Weinstock, working for the Illuminati at the time, initialized his secret society as the Enlightened Ones. And so the order was founded to provide an opportunity for the free exchange of those ideas. And so Adam Weinstock was a Jesuit, and he had in his influence of the actual character of the society was very, very strong. And he had a very huge desire to see the abolishment of Christianity and an overturn of every single civil government on earth to be conformed to the Illuminati. And another close friend of Albert Pike, and another man he deeply respected and admired, was an Italian revolutionary leader. His name was Gillespie Mazzini. And Mazzini, who was born in 1805 and he died in 1872, he was a 33rd degree Freemason and a high-ranking blood member of the Illuminati. And Mazzini was selected by the Illuminati to head their worldwide operations in 1834. And I said worldwide operations. Mazzini had a lot of power over a lot of powerful people in the world. And so Mazzini also founded Cosa Nostra. He was the founder of the Mafia. The Mafia is scared to death of the Illuminati, and there's a reason why, because the Illuminati gave birth to the Mafia through Mazzini. Because of Mazzini's revolutionary activities in Europe, the Bavarian government cracked down on the Illuminati and other secret societies for plotting the overthrow of their governments at the time. So, see, the Illuminati was supposed to remain secret. But Mazzini was such the outspoken member of the Illuminati, and he exercised so much of his power that he stepped on a few toes on the day government, meaning the government that you see, to the point where they got a little tired of his activities, that they had to punish him. And so the secrets of the Illuminati were getting revealed at that time, because during this punishment on Mazzini, during an investigation into Mazzini's life, many of the Illuminati's plans were coming out because of what they were finding out about Mazzini, because they were prosecuting him. And so to reestablish themselves, they had to send Mazzini away. And so by doing that, they basically exiled him. So during his leader during that time, Mazzini incited Albert Pike into the now into the Illuminati to take more of a high position and more of a high role. So Albert Pike had to pick off on the work that Mazzini had to leave behind. Mazzini couldn't do the worldwide work anymore. So Pike was fascinated by the idea of being a high man for the one world government. So when asked by Mazzini to take over his post for a while, he readily agreed to do so. And so he wrote a ritual tome at the time when he was chosen that guided the transition from average high-ranking Mason into a now a top-ranking Illuminati Mason of the 33rd degree. And so since Mazzini gave this to Pike, and Pike wanted to head the Illuminati through America within that way. So the switch from the Italian office then came into the American office. So he clearly felt Pike was worthy of such a task, and so Mazzini's intention was that once a Mason had made his way up the Freemason ladder and proven himself worthy, the highest ranking members of Freemason would then be offered membership to the secret society within a society, the Illuminati. And so, as do most occultists, Albert Pike had a spirit guide who dispensed divine wisdom and enlightened him regarding of how to achieve the New World Order. Who is the spirit guide? It is a demon that possesses him, the demons that live among him. And so a spirit guide is a being who meets someone who has given themselves over to the practice of the satanic occult or the religion of Satan. However, people who are practitioners of the New Age religion do not view this as a bad thing. In fact, they would strongly agree that they are filled with happiness and joy by interacting with these spirit guides. Oprah Winfrey gives these spirit guides a huge build-up, and so does many, many others. You know, there's a whole list of them, and very well-known ones who have, you know, admitted to people that they are possessed by spirits. And they call these spirits their friends, their buddies, their companions. What they fail to tell you is all the nightmares and headaches and hauntings and mental insanity that they have to deal with day in and day out, and the hatred of this type of breed. And so they're very much enslaved by these spirits, and so Albert Pike was on that level. He looked at his demon possession as a spirit guide rather than what it is, a possession. So moving on, one message that Albert Pike received from this demonic spirit guide, and which in reality we know to be a demonic vision, he described a letter that he wrote to Manzini, but it was actually written to the Illuminati, because the Illuminati chose Albert Pike through that initiation to bring forth the message from Satan. Satan had a very, very, very important message to give to the Illuminati. It was the message to how to orchestrate three world wars. And Albert Pike was the one chosen to deliver the message. So on August 15th, 1871, Albert Pike's spirit guide, his demon, sat him down, and through automatic writing, Albert Pike outlined plans for three world wars that were seen as necessary to bring about the one world order. And we can marvel at how accurately it has predicted events that have already taken place. This is not because the devil knows everything, but this is to say that the devil has some powers of prophecy because he's kept alive through the Bible. The devil read the Bible long before anyone else has, and he has a better understanding of it than human beings. So he knows future events, and he knows them because he knows they have to come to pass in accordance to God's plan. He knows his role in that event, is to say. You know, he knows what he can and cannot do in the event. He knows he has a purpose in that event, so it has to be revealed to him. So thus the devil revealed it to Albert Pike. And because his the Illuminati agents have undertaken to manipulate political events so much, now they manipulate political events to closely follow these three designs. So what are these three designs now? I'm going to read to you the very first world war as was planned by Albert Pike, mostly planned by Satan, because you can't say it was planned by Albert Pike. Albert Pike got the idea from a demonic spirit, a fallen angel, appeared to him and told him how you're going to initialize these three world wars and give this message to the high-ranking Illuminati Council, make them known what I have to say. Now, this letter and all three of these wars were written in August 15th, 1871. And we know World War happened after 1900. And so this is how Albert Pike prophesied the First World War. The First World War must be brought about in order to permit the Illuminati to overthrow the power of the Khazars in Russia and of making that country a fortress of atheistic communism. The divergence caused by the agents of the Illuminati between the British and German empires will be used to foment this war. At the end of the war, communism will be built and used in order to destroy the other governments and in order to weaken religion. So what happened? Did that happen just like that? Yes, it did. This happened just like that, and it was written in 1871. During the First World War, the Khazars of Russia were destroyed and communism took over. During the First World War, it was started between the British and the German empires. During the First World War and after World War I, communism destroyed many, many, many countries along the way to submit to its former government. It happened exactly the way Albert Pike, through Satan, written in 1871. Now I'm going to describe to you the Second World War. And the Second World War, once again, was written in 1871. And we know when did World War, well, World War II started in the late 30s, but for us it started in 41. But it was a war that was planned in 1871. So how accurate did they plan World War II in 1871? Well, let's read it. The Second World War must be fomented by taking advantage of the differences between the fascists and the political Zionists. This war must be brought about so that Nazism is destroyed and that the political Zionism be strong enough to institute a sovereign state of Israel and Palestine. During the Second World War, international communism must become strong enough in order to balance Christendom, which would be then restrained and held in check until the time when we would need it for the final social catalysis. So did it happen just like that? Yes, it did. The Second World War, during the time when it was starting up, the two most powerful political fronts within the movements were the fascists and the Zionists. And the Zionists represented people who had an objective to see Israel become a sovereign state, and the fascists had an objective to see Israel not become a fascist state and to repress Israelites. So Nazism, there's another one about that too. Why is a guy talking about Nazism in 1871? Why is a guy talking about Nazism in regards to a Second World War in 1871? That's quite a bit this guy saw. And yes, that's exactly what happened. Nazism was to be destroyed. So apparently, Nazism was something small time in 1871, but Albert Pike foresaw that it would grow into something so huge that it would be on a worldwide scale, and that in the Second World War, its influence had to be destroyed. Thus, Hitler... defeat was prophesized. You know, it's kind of interesting. Hitler would have then known that he was supposed to lose World War II. I guess his plans was not about winning, it was about something else.